Hi, this is Jinya, and I'm going to talk about Beijing Opera. Beijing Opera, also called Jingju, is a traditional Chinese theater. It first arose in Beijing and then gradually spread to the whole country and even the world. It's now the national opera and the largest Chinese opera today.
Beijing Opera is one type of music theater and a dance drama. Dance is really significant in opera in the 20th century. It's an exaggeration, but people sometimes say that all of the movement is dance. So dancing, acting, and singing are more important than the literary elements, and the scripts are not text but meme points, so the actors can make their role their own. Usually, the actors won't perform the whole story from the beginning to the end, but only perform some famous plots and use narrative to help it connect together. Masks are used to symbolically highlight elements of the personality and the history of the characters. The makeup and costume did a lot of character work. Actors use paints made from egg white and oil to decorate their faces in old time. Different type of characters has different makeup and costumes. There are more than 250 types of makeup and 300 types of dress. These costumes are color-coded, which means red and yellow robes with dragon patterns are associated with high officials and loyal ones, and white and gray clothes are for old ones.
Beijing Opera has lasted for more than 200 years since the early 19th century. At the very beginning, to celebrate Emperor Qianlong's 80th birthday, troops from different places came to Beijing in 1790. They stayed there and eventually combined their different dramatic forms and created a new style, which is Beijing Opera. It was well developed and recognized by the public by the mid-19th century. As there was no restriction of space and time for onstage performance, it was day-to-day performed and combined as part of people's daily life. Performances were centered in the old commercial center of Beijing, the Tiananmen Gate Tower area, where it's next to Tiananmen Square. A lot of popular and famous Beijing opera artists lived and performed there. It was usually performed in the restaurant theater and the tea house, and Tiananmen Gate Tower had many of them. Also, it was popular for wealthy families to invite troops to their houses to perform for themselves privately. From the mid-20th century, huge theater houses were built and Beijing Opera started to be staged there. There are some popular playwrights like Sheng Kuilu, born in 1822 and died in 1890. One of the most famous plays, History of the Three Kingdoms, was written by him. Han Qiguan, his famous play was Injustice to Douge and Lan Feng Mei. He was an expert in performing the role of Dan and wrote the play Farewell, My Concubine. There are two typical stories in Beijing opera.
One is Wen, means civil, and the other is Wu, means military.
The first one is about lyrical love stories, and the second one is about heroic stories. The inspiration comes from Chinese theology, history, other work of literature, legends, and cosmology. There are four types of characters. Each of them has its own movements, pitch, rhythm, and acting techniques. The first one is Sheng, means man. There are seven types of Sheng roles. For makeup, they use flower for a white base and has red lips and eyes outlined it in red. The second one is Dan, means woman. Dan roles were played by men, and women took over it into the 20th century. Dan's makeup is similar with Sheng. There are three categories of the Dan roles. The Jing Yi means noble young lady, the Hua Dan means beautiful woman, and the Lao Dan means old woman.
The next one is Jing, means painted face roles. Jing includes roles like patriotic heroes, demons, gods, and other mythological characters. They have the most complex designs of makeup. They usually wear shoes that can add as much as 20 cm to their height to build this personality of larger than life. The last one is Chou, means clowns. They are the joke teller. They usually wear white patches around their eyes and nose. They do not usually sing because their jokes are easy for the audience to understand by using pure colloquial language. They can be both good and bad characters like farmers, playboys, or even emperors. Beijing Opera flourished for more than 150 years until the People's Republic of China was founded in 1949. It was recognized as a popular art form, but there is a need for reform and change, as the communists believed. Many plays were banned and removed because they were considered too violent, having sexual suggestiveness, or being regarded as reactionary politics. This change was even more serious when the Cultural Revolution began in 1966. After the Cultural Revolution, Beijing Opera is being protected as an intangible cultural heritage in China, so the opera people watch today is virtually the same as what people viewed 200 years ago in the Qing Dynasty. Although it is still performed today, it's not as popular as it was in the old days. And here are some popular plays, like the Farewell My Concubine, Injustice to Douyi, Lady Zhaojun Going Beyond the Great Wall, and The Drunken Beauty. Symbols are also used in Beijing opera. There are usually two chairs and a table on the stage. They can represent a wall, a tree, a mountain, or bed, etc. It depends on how they arrange them. They can be whatever they need. Other symbols include a silver banner represents water, a black robe represents a storm, and a yellow flag suggests that actors are in a chariot. That's everything, and thank you for watching.